Hey everybody, I hope you're doing really good today. I kind of came across this video. It's on Katie's YouTube. And what kind of sparked my interest was this title, Mary Brown's Erratic Bizarre Behavior Following Big Move Worries Fans. Is Mary numbing her pain? Are you kidding me? The only person that I know of that quote unquote numbs their pain is Katie fucking Joy. She drinks on a regular basis. She takes Adderall, and you're not supposed to drink with Adderall, but okay, you're gonna sit there and call out Mary? Really? Yeah, okay, let's get into this.
Hey everyone, it's Katie from Without a Crystal Ball. Welcome back to my channel. It's Monday, May 1st, 2023. I hope you are having a wonderful day. All right, we just went back to the past. We talked about this weird welfare food stamps slash bankruptcy filing by Christine. We know that back in the day, the wives had a lot of financial issues and...
And that's the problem with her. Why the hell is she going back in the past and bringing things up or making shit up? Oh, that's why. You're out of content, so you just make up fucking lies.
Obviously, that plagues the communities that are the polygamists. Now, many of these wives have gone out on their own, and they're in the real world. Their lives in the real world are very different than those that generally leave these groups and don't have the resources and the money that the Browns have. Mary Brown is one of those women that's extremely lucky to have left the system, be financially secure, own her own home, and have friends to fall back on. Now, Fridays with Friends is this thing she does on her Instagram, and a lot of you guys have been asking me to talk about these. I've talked about them in the past. She can get really sassy. She has thrown shade at Christine in the past on these. She sometimes appears drunk. A lot of you are concerned that Mary is an alcoholic. And
who the fuck are you to call out people being drunk? Have you seen your lives? Have you seen your videos? You delete over half of them because you're fucking drunk 24/7. Are you kidding me? Wow.
I don't speculate on that because honestly,
yes, you
I go
do.
live on my Instagram and people assume I'm intoxicated. I think
you are, Katie. You sit there with your wine and drink it every goddamn time you're on Instagram Live. It used to be every single day, but because your ass got called out, now you don't do it every single day. But I see more and more now that you're going live. And every single time you're live, you're drinking wine, red wine. That's your go-to.
If people are off the cuff and silly, they are automatically accused of being drunk. Okay, so
why is it you're allowed to call Mary erratic, bizarre, and drunk, but yet when you actually are erratic and bizarre and drunk, we can't call you out? Please explain that.
Mary Brown has a tendency to act a little bit silly, kind of erratic, maybe weird on these Fridays with Friends. And the Fridays with Friends, frequently the last several weeks, are so off the cuff, no direction. The conversations don't seem to go anywhere. They don't really talk about anything. And the comments from this week, people are like worried about her and they're convinced she was wasted. So I'll show you some clips of this and we can talk about it. But before we do, can you please do me a big favor and give this video a thumbs up? Also, please subscribe
Oh,
to my
shut
channel if
the
you've not
fuck up.
going on with Mary. I don't want to speculate that she is drinking. I don't want to speculate that she is drunk. I don't want to.
Did she or did KJ just not speculate? Are you fuck? Wow, I just can't with this lady.
Speculate about any of that. What I will say is that I'll share with you the comments that are from her Instagram with people saying that she is drunk and that they're convinced she is drinking and others are concerned about her well-being. I got the sense that she might be having a good time here, but I will say this, is that sometimes when people leave polygamy, it can be like their entire fracture, like their whole world sort of like falls underneath them. And a couple of weeks ago, she and Jen were on a Fridays with Friends and they were talking about how when they met, you know, Jen was...
You know, she sits there and is talking shit on Mary, but you notice how she can't even finish a sentence, let alone finish a goddamn word? But you're talking about how Mary's erratic and bizarre and drunk. Okay, KJ, you go.
Referring to Mary as a polygamist.
Spend
and Mary just sort of like had this like aha moment where she's like, wait a minute, I'm not a polygamist anymore. Like I was a polygamist. Your entire identity, when your entire identity and your like your future, your eternity, your happiness, your family.
Okay, this is gonna sound a little nuts, but the fastest and easiest way to make passive online income on Amazon.
Your happiness, your family's eternity, sealed for time and all eternity, your faith is wrapped up in a very oppressive cult and you have had these like ideas that are very, very radical and very...
Is KJ not speculating right now? She doesn't know how Mary feels. She doesn't know what Mary's doing. She doesn't even know Mary. This is called speculation. So KJ, shut the fuck up.
Hard to believe, but that's the life you've lived and you've been brainwashed to believe this your whole life. And then you're out of that and you're in your 50s. It's like she has coming into the real world now in her 50s and she's like doing it in real time.
That was how she had to point out that she's 50 twice.
On Instagram Live, okay? So she's in a lot of ways for the first time single. Completely now, in her own home, not in the same town as Cody anymore, not a part of a family anymore. She is completely on her own. A lot of times when people leave polygamy or a high pressure or high control cult, they can fall into a lot of issues. There are some cults, like the FLDS, that people that leave, there's high incidences of those who die by suicide. Others that end up turning to drugs and alcohol. Others that get into depression because...
So now you're speculating that she could commit suicide or turn to drugs and alcohol, or that she already has. But remember, you don't speculate.
When you leave, you're not just leaving the person or that life. You're leaving, like, your identity, and you're leaving everything that was happening before that and after. And you have to figure out life on your own now. And it's a lot for people to handle. And then people process trauma and they go through really dark times. And so if she's drinking, I just want to say that wouldn't surprise me. And if she is drinking, I would say try not to be too hard on her. So I wanted to show you a few clips that got people sort of like riled up, and then I'll share the comments with you and you can decide.
I actually got to the place where I was going, and it's like a federal institution. And we're not in jail. Maybe. I know yes. She thinks this is, hey, listen, nothing is wrong with Vegas, Miss Honeybee. And Jen,
I can give you a bullet pointed list.
I like Vegas. I'm just saying. And that's fine. I'm sure.
There is so much pink.
So much pink. It is coral.
Which is
right?
Pink.
Jinx's mommy? It is so coral. It's kind of like a dusty
salmon.
Coral.
That's not pink.
So someone has to be like the thingies that hang from the tree.
Oh, it looked like a really giant
alarum.
Dead bug.
Aluminium linoleum.
Not
we are in a barn where we were raised.
See, I told you. The words were failing me. Please hold. I need my drink and it's holding this phone up. So hold on.
You guys, I love the saying, you were born in a bar and you see drama happening in this town. It's a big deal. That was only halfway intentional. Anyways, my friend, I was like, I want to like spite join a pickleball league just to be.
All right. So basically they set at a park and they're at a pavilion.
Wow. So that looks to me like these ladies are having a hell of a time. And I honestly, I wish I was there with them. It sounds like a great time. If they're drinking, who gives a fuck? Leave her alone, Katie.
And they had dinner and they're just silly, right? And they're laughing and they're all over the place and they're slapping the table and it seems like they might have had some cocktails. Now, Mary doesn't drink, according to her, and she almost always says she's drinking water. And they have no ability to stay on conversation.
Don't even go there. Your little sippy cup is never filled with water. Nice try, honey.
And I only showed you like a tiny little amount of it. I tried to watch most of it, but they were so all over the place.
Wow.
They were like in between, like going in and out and slapping on the table and then like laughing. And then they sometimes sounded like they had been drinking and other times they didn't. And I don't, like I said, care. But when I went into
obviously
her comments,
you do.
These are what the comments said. What time did the party start? Drunk 30? Another person said, sounding a bit tipsy, Mary.
Listen, KG's like, I'm not going to speculate, but yet she has to point this out just to bring Mary down. You see what I'm saying? Nothing good ever comes out of KJ's mouth. Nothing good will ever come out of KJ. People, it's time to cancel KJ. It's done. It's over. She's done. You need to follow your little friend Uni Rock there and go all the way down the barrel and not come the fuck back out.
And then someone said, is this for real? People actually watch this?
They watch
okay.
Your ass.
So I think that Fridays with Friends started as a good idea and a good concept, but sometimes when they go on there, they literally have nothing to talk about. And so they spend a lot of their time just like staring at the comments and just answering questions. And sometimes they have like their side conversations. And the problem with Fridays with Friends is that she posts it after. And so you don't see like the comments because you can't see the people that are commenting in the live stream. So you don't know what they're answering. So that's one issue. So you have no idea the context of what they're talking about. But the drunk question or the drunk comments were like, are y'all drunk? Mary is crunk. It's fine if you're a little tipsy, Mary. You deserve it. Being married to your ex, Cody, don't let nobody put you down. Love you. Someone wrote, 10 minutes of my life. I can't get back. I like Mary, but this is painful to watch and pointless. Seriously, being drunk doesn't help you. She sounds tipsy most of the time.
Look at how she's clipped out all the good comments, but made sure she had all of these bad ones up. Like, that is disgusting. That's disgusting. You're disgusting, Katie.
Your friend is so weird. Her friend is so weird. Everyone says Mary's drunk in this video, and she very well could be. She deserves to be after the life she's had to live. You go, Mary. Someone else said, it seems from the outside looking in that it is, that drinking to excess is a frequent event for Mary and her friend. Your life experiences coupled with this behavior is fraught with dangerous outcomes for you. Best to stop and check it with yourself and watch your posts when you're not alcohol affected. Obviously, a lot of people think she's drunk. And she could be.
And obviously, you like relevishing in that because you seem to think that you're up on your high and mighty and you're better than everybody. So you like to trash everyone. And that's the whole reason why you did this video.
She could be. I think what strikes people is that I think what people are responding to is that the Mary that she's on Fridays with Friends is not the Mary that you see on the show. On the show, Mary's always depressed and sad and she never laughs and she looks sad all the time because she was with a jerk of a husband and in an unhappy marriage and stuck in a situation where she probably felt hopeless. When she's with her friend, Jen, obviously...
Again, more speculation, but she told us at the beginning she wasn't going to speculate.
She's with her friend. She has no guards up. She's just being who she is. She's being silly and goofy. I think the going in and out, truthfully, is partially that she can't read the comments and she's trying to read the comments. And she's probably like me, where it's as you age, your vision gets worse. And so you have to like squint to see the comments. So I think that's part of it. And I think that the other thing is that because they're Mormons, or they're like, well, Mormons, and then fundamentalists at that, like the polygamists, they're teetotalers. They don't drink. And here's the weird thing, though.
Yeah, KJ just said that she wasn't in, Mary wasn't in that no more. So make up your fucking mind.
Is that even though they say that they don't drink, I know that some closet drink.
Look at the skin, baby. She is glowing. She is one of one.
With new Olay Hyaluronic Body Wash, 95% of women had visibly better skin.
My skin is so much more moisturized.
See the difference with Olay.
Fellow robots, new Goldfish Megabytes, not Megabytes, have big cheddar jalapeno flavor. Jaw-dropping flavor. Goldfish Megabytes, mega flavor, mega size, mega crunch.
I know that some closet are closet drinkers and closet drug users. So they might claim.
Yeah, you just called exactly what you are, a closet drinker and a closet drug user only. You actually tell people, you dumb fuck.
To be abstinent of alcohol and drugs, but then they actually drink. So on the show, they would go places and have a cocktail. I know that people have seen Cody and Robin out and they've had drinks. With Mary, she's always adamantly said, like, I do not drink alcohol. I'm not a drinker, which I think makes people more believe that she's like hiding it. And so I think that deceptiveness of her saying she doesn't drink makes people like play the game more that she does drink. I will say this, and my advice to me, to Mary would be, is if you want to make this like a regular thing and you want
to
have...
My advice to me, exactly. That's all everything ever is about you, isn't it, Katie?
People engaged in this, it would be good to actually have a topic to discuss. It would be good to be less like reactive to the chat and just talk about whatever
the
topic
is
that you want to talk about. They go off in so many different directions that I think is that they're reacting to the chat where it appears like more ADHD. And I can say that because I have ADHD, is that like
no,
you start
I don't
one
think
topic
you do.
And you go to the next and you go to the next and you go to the next before you even finish a thought, because she's
you're
reacting
just
to
like
the
Adderall.
Chat. I don't know if she's drunk. And honestly, you guys, if she is drunk, let her be drunk. Who else would not want it? I mean, after what she's been through with Cody, would you not want to be drunk? I would. Tell me in the comments if you would want to be drunk. After a 30-year marriage where you've been, three wives have been brought in, you've been displaced three times, you've had to deal with your husband's infidelity while pretending that it's a religion, you've lost your parents, you've been moved around a million times, you've had financial upheaval, you...
Even her teeth are getting worse. Holy fuck. Like, go to a doctor. Clearly you need help.
You've been accused of abusing all of your different kids, which maybe she did. She's been accused of being a jerk. She's been accused of being not nice to people.
Are you serious?
She's
you just said maybe she did abuse all her kids? Are you fucking kidding me? Like, who the fuck are you? Wow.
Tormented. I mean, she's tormented people and they've tormented her.
You
so
torment
she wants to drink,
people.
Maybe she should just drink. I think fans just aren't used to it because they're supposed to be fundamentalists. So is that what you're responding to? I don't know. Tell me what your thoughts are in the comments below.
Wow, you're a joke, bud. Anyways, wow. I don't even know what to say exactly about that. That is insane. This chick is insane. She's got nothing nice to say about anything or anybody. And this whole thing was just so she can bitch and whatever all about Mary. Wow. All right. Well, I guess that'll be it for me, you guys. Hopefully you enjoyed. And I'm going to try and get the hell out of here. Just let me know what you think in the comment section. And I can't even turn it off. Oh, there we go. Bye.